Welcome, this is Paul's Model Train Stuff, and today I have a very old Fleischmann made in Western Germany. Its case is fully made out of metal. I don't have any magnet here to prove it, but trust me, it is. I got it as a part of a bigger bunch of other trains, and this was one of them. It's really, really heavy, and I like the feel of it. I think it's missing stuff on the top here, and I'm very curious if it's gonna run. If it is, it's gonna be a short video. If it's not, it's gonna be a longer video. I think I can hear the distinct sound of something shorting out, so that's not good. Let's see what's inside here. Let's just start with this screw and see if I can lift this whole thing up. Here we go. Let's get the weight out. Not that it saves a lot in the weight, it's still pretty heavy. So those are some pretty big diodes in here, just to run the small lights. Now let's see what's up with this. The engine here looks like it's not missing any parts. So let's get the trusty meter out. Usually just put it on continuity to see if anything is shorting out. That's not good. It's supposed to give me some resistance through the engine and not a dead short. That's a good start. What's in here? Someone's been soldering this. Okay, this shouldn't be causing any issues. So something in the wheels here. Now I can see a big screw that looks like a good starting point, although I'm not sure what will fall off if I... Well, there's only one way to find out. Let's see what's gonna break. Oh, that's nice. That's really nice. There we have the... Okay, so the black wire goes to the iron part here to connect to the wheels on the side, and over here there's the brown, and that's gonna connect to those wheels. Good. That's easy. And then let the screw drop out. There we go. Let's see if anything is going on in here. If I remove all the wires, if the wheels are okay. I can't imagine they're not being okay. But I don't want to find out afterwards. So this is just the wheels. That's not good. So there's something going on in here that's not quite right, because those wheels should not short out at all. Okay, now over here. Grab this one and that one, and that's also a short. Okay. Now, I'm very curious why these wheels are shorting out. They shouldn't. Maybe someone replaced them at some point. That's definitely not good. But it's not going. It's not shorting out through the axle. No, it's not shorting out through the axle. It's now not shorting at all. What's this? It. Maybe. No, those are pretty. What's going on here? Is it touching something somewhere? It's. How can this. How can it short out without going through the axle? Maybe it's not dirt. Metal. Of course. That's good. That's good. That part is okay, so it's somewhere in here. Duh. This and this is shorting out. Now, is it the engine? I'd say it's more likely in all the lighting. So I'm gonna desolder the lighting. I wish I could just desolder the lighting. Which one is what? Gonna get rid of that. Hopefully the other one will stay on. Almost. That solves the lighting part. Now let's see what the engine itself does. Is it because I'm working on metal again? Let's see if I can get something. Some shielding in place. I bet these doodles will do. I know it's not a good idea to work on a metal workbench, but it's the best I have right now. So the lights are okay and there's something here going on. That's a shame. I was hoping this was all okay. Maybe it was just bad luck and it was shorting out on the position the engine was, the motor was. But no. That should not short it out. That's just to suppress noise. This is going in here and isn't going anywhere else, so I think it's time to try to get the whole motor out. Okay, motor out, I was gonna say. Oh, stuff dropping everywhere. Okay, from here to here. What is going on here? Is maybe you, brush it against this. That's not the same. You're going to the chassis. You're not. Something must be shorting out somewhere. Yeah. I think this is again one to pause and to figure out what the hell is going on here. So I'll be back a bit later. It is alive! It's not very smooth yet. Redid a lot of the wiring, and that seems to solve some of its issues. It appeared that the wiring from this end went to here, and also the black wire went to here, and then things go bad. So I'm now still in the progress of soldering all the wires back on the correct spot. It's obvious someone has been soldering on this earlier, and I am not sure that what I did now is actually the way it's supposed to be soldered together, but at least it is now working. This should go here, this should go here. So now just putting everything together, and it's been quite messy. I even suspect that the wiring here on this end was the wrong way around. Let me get the screws out. Here we go. It's now only a matter of putting the whole locomotive back together. I must say it's quite hard with all the wires pulling, but I don't feel like desoldering everything again, screwing everything back together and then soldering it. So I'm trying to do it like this, and it's just things drop and pulling from everywhere. It's not nice, but I'll get it in. And I hope that with the proper weight on it, this will run smoothly again, because it's... Oh, for Christ's sake. It is a nice looking one. It's a nice looking engine. Just so messed up with all the wiring. It's not my lucky day with the screws today. No, get it, no. Just too little room. Yes. Got it. Yeah, so I started off checking several of the connections, and I ended up desoldering about everything, and I just using my own knowledge to figure out where everything should be, not where everything was. One on. That's for the lights. That will go here, that will go there. There's no tension on the wires, everything is soldered in. Get this here. How did that work again? this not too long ago. Where is the... Nope. I think it's this one. And otherwise I'll just have to, excuse me, look back on the video to figure out which screw it actually was. Wrong screwdriver. I find this one, this train, really, I'd say magnificent. So big and heavy, really love it. I think I've got one wire. Maybe we can untangle them, and then I should have enough room. There we go. Is this one? Could be. Not out, and how it is grabbing it. There we go. My big lump of iron. Yep, not lead. That's good. Oh, something went wrong. Oh, that's for the lights. Resolder that, but I'm first gonna see if this is gonna run again if I just put it back together. It's not good yet. It's not aligned properly, and it's shorting out again. Oh God. Dear old God, what happened? What went wrong? Maybe it's... No. I am first gonna get rid of this wire here, so I have some more room to maneuver. Back on the track. The engine is running, but I'm also hearing it shorting out. Is this? I think this was touching the frame. Still making sounds as if it was is still shorting out somewhere, but at least it is. It can do better than this, but it is working. Now for the lights. Let's see, it's using the whole frame to get the current back. Okay, so this wire is gonna go on here. Oh, normally I am I don't use the normal stripping. It usually just works like this, but not today. This getting this out, getting that on. Come on, come on, come on. That is some ugly solder joint. But with that back on, this can go back in here. Yes. Sort of. And this can go back here as well, and it is, let's see, which one did they use? Use this. I see there are some drilling holes that are unused. I'm gonna look at pictures of these, and I hope to find some can find this train in old catalogs to see what's supposed to be on here. Maybe I'm able to find some of that. Oh, that's not correct. Maybe I'll be able to find what's supposed to be on there and get those parts back. This back. And wire back in. Okay. Turning it around. I think this on that side needs some more tidying up. Screw. Oops. Get this centered. I hope I have it in the correct spot now, and it will, yep, go right in. I'm very confident it's still working, but yes, there we go. It's slow, I think it's still shorting out somewhere, but at least the engine is running, the motor is running. So I'm gonna see, that's not what I'd like. Nope. So it's still shorting out on this end. Something is wrong here, but I'm gonna look at that another time. I think if I have that sorted out, it will move a lot faster than it's doing now, but this video is long enough as it is. So I hope you enjoyed this beautiful old piece of mechanics from Fleischmann. And me, of course, and if you want to see more, you can subscribe to my channel. And I hope to do more of these videos soon, because I still have a box full of old stuff.